Blockchain is a distributed public ledger or database where every participant in the network has a copy of the ledger, and every transaction in the network is updated in all ledgers. As I said, blockchain is a distributed public ledger. Every participant holds a copy of the ledger, and all transactions are recorded in all ledgers. And these transactions are compiled into blocks and secured using cryptography. Then each new block is placed on top of existing block with a link to the previous block. So it has three portions. Block. Block is where the list, the combined list of transactions are held. And the chain part is, chain part comes because each block is linked with the previous block using cryptographic algorithms. So that is the chain part of it. And distributed ledger, it is where all the transactions are recorded and stored. So that is the ledger part of it. And this is how a typical blockchain looks like. If you look at the right side, you can see that is a traditional database. A traditional database is just like a table where all new records are entered either on top of the table or at the bottom, right? But as I said, in blockchain, the transactions are not entered as records. A number of transactions are compressed or compiled into a block. You can imagine like a register book, and every block is a page. But in a register, and every page will contain a number of transactions, number of records. But the only difference would be, in a register, every page is linked at the common point. If you can just pin one to another and make a chain out of those pages, you can imagine that way. See, every page will contain the hash value of the previous page. So that is how a blockchain looks like. And a block contains, in addition to transactions, a block contains few other parameters. These are called headers. It is timestamp. Timestamp says when the block is created, and hash of previous block. This is where the linkage, that chain part, is coming from. And there will be a nonce. We will come to that nonce later. And there will be other parameters like blockchain version and difficulty level. There are few other parameters which are not relevant for the purpose of this presentation, right? How to compile a ledger? We said the transactions will be validated by the peer level, people in the peer level or computers in the network, right? Now, there may be thousands of transactions happened since last 5 or 10 minutes. So all the transaction has to be compressed into the new block. So it is called, the process is called creating Merkle tree. As I said, proof of work is a way of solving, it's a protocol, it's a way of solving a puzzle. And this concept, it was created in 1997 when people started the denial of service attack, like sending spam mails. There was a protocol called Hashcash. This was devised in 1997 to prevent receiving a lot of spam mails. The purpose is, if I have to accept what you are giving me, you have to prove that you have done enough work or you have spent enough computing resources in creating that. Then only I accept what you give me, what you send me, be it a mail or be it a cryptocurrency. That is the basic idea behind it. So proof of work is, as I said, every block will contain the hash value of a previous block. And the miner, in order to create a block, has to compile all these transactions, has to add timestamp and hash of previous block, and one more element, which is nonce, right? This nonce is a random number. So the puzzle is to find such a random number which, when combined with other parameters and hashed, will produce a hash value which will have n number of leading zeros.
And there are other applications of blockchain. There is something called smart contracts. As I said, blockchain is a distributed public ledger where transactions are recorded. These transactions can be anything. It can be you are dealing with your property, you are purchasing a new car, or these are transactions. So you can record any transaction on blockchain, right? And even our biometric information or digital identity, even licenses issued by universities or other organizations, anything you can store in a blockchain, which can be verified by all. So these are other applications. And when it comes to smart contracts, these are basically computer programs. This Bitcoin network doesn't support this. That Bitcoin network is only designed for generating cryptocurrencies and transferring cryptocurrencies. But there are other blockchains like Ethereum, Ripples, there are many, right? This Ethereum is designed to support programming. Means anyone can write new programs on top of Ethereum blockchain. So these smart contracts are basically let me ask, what is a contract? It is basically a number of terms and conditions. So if you can just create a flowchart or algorithm out of that terms and conditions and write it in the form of a computer program that can be stored on a blockchain. And once the conditions are met, accordingly, currency can be transacted. Like you are just making, we have AMC, and someone else is repairing our computers or maintaining our computers. When we click, okay, their condition is satisfactory, say click a button. So without, then we need not to process internally. We'll be doing getting approval from accounts department, all these things. All these things can be avoided. We can simply, we can program it in such a way, once the conditions are met, the network will transfer the amount by default. So that is what a smart contract is. And these are the issues with blockchain. As I said, it consumes a lot of electricity, huge amount of electricity. And in blockchain, I said your wallet will generate a key pair, a private key and a public key. This private key is your password. But once you lose your private key, there is no way. In a usual online banking, if you lose your password, you can just request to the bank or other authority and you can get reset your password. But here there are no such options. Once you lose your private key, you lost everything.
There is specific to an device?
Yes. Not device. See, you are installing a Bitcoin wallet, say in case of Bitcoin network, it will give you a private key. You are supposed to keep it. Usually in digital signatures also we use private key. We keep it in a pen drive or in your computer.
You lose that, you've gone.
You've gone. There is no way of retrieving it. It is lost forever in the network. Right? That is a possible threat. But there are certain organizations which gives you locker where you can keep your private key. In turn, they will give you a password. But that will compromise the very purpose of blockchain. Right? And that is creating lot of news in these days. People are losing their money and all this. And these transactions are not reversible. In a typical banking, by mistake, suppose you send someone, you can just complain or lodge a complaint with your bank or credit card company, and they can do something to sort out the dispute. But there is no middle agency to sort out any issue. And standardization. At ISO level, there is a committee, ISO TC307, Blockchain and Distributed Ledger Technologies. And we have a national mirror committee, LITD 30, with the same title, Blockchain and Distributed Technologies. And these are the projects undergoing in the ISO committee. And in LITD, we created that LITD 30 very recently, and we are just initiating the work.